Shalom everybody and welcome to Rega Be'ivrit. My name is Rabbi Dr. Yitzhak Shapira and I'm here to take you now to the book of Bamidbar in a very special edition. This year in Bamidbar we're going through the Ramazim of the Chachamim that have to do with the coming of Mashiach. This Shabbat we find ourselves in the book of Numbers chapter 6 verse 24-25, that deals specifically with the Aaronic benediction, Birkat HaKohanim, the blessing that Aaron and his son have left to Israel. First of all, it's important to note that only a Kohen can give this blessing. If there is not a Kohen, a Levi can bring this blessing. And if it's not a Levi, one from Klal Israel can give this blessing. What's so special about this blessing? That start with the word Yevechecha Adonai Veishmarecha. It starts with the Lord bless you and guard you. I want to show you something incredible in this passage. As you are well aware of this word, the word here Chazal says in Numbers Rabbah, it says the four, Adonai will protect you and bless you and keep you. Well, it's not exactly keeping. The Hebrew word is the word yishamrecha. It's come from the Hebrew word shomer, which means to guard. God will bless you and God will guard you. And this is the amazing thing. Listen to what it said in Bamidbar Rabbah. It says that the word shomer, to guard you or to keep you, it's to preserve you until the end. It's a connection to Acharit HaYamim. God will protect you until the end. What did Yeshua teach us? He teach us that we have to hold on until the end. This is significant and this is important. Listen, the connection to that is found in the book of Isaiah chapter 21. And listen to that, he says, Misham Adomei Elai Koreh Mesair. Where is he calling for you? The protector. The protector is calling you from Sa'ir. He's calling you from Edom. Isn't it amazing to know that the one who said upon Israel today, Yevechecha Adonai Veishmarecha, is the one who is calling it from inside Edom, inside Sa'ir. Who is that? Edom, Sa'ir, Esav, is all the names that related to Mashiach. To Mashiach. Now look at this. This is incredible. The Messiah today is calling upon each and every one of us, especially in Acharit HaYamim, and say, Evercha Adonai Vishmarecha, I will guard you till the end. If you're going to do the right thing in the last days. It is well known what it says in the Midrash, that Israel is delivered only through Teshuvah. Only through Teshuvah, Israel is delivered. Ve'en adavar talui ela b'teshuvah. Without repentance, there is no geula. Now look at this. This is important. Yevechecha Adonai veishmarecha. Think about this. Those are the most important words in our prayer, in our shacharit, in our ma'ariv, in our mincha, that are recited. What is Messiah telling us? So the one that is telling us that is Messiah. Now the word ishmor, Yod, Shin, Mem, Resh, is what you must do in order for him to preserve you to the end, as Messiah said. Look at this. The letter Shin, it's come from the Hebrew word Shochad, mean bribery. The first thing you must do is to avoid bribery in the last day. Conduct your business cleanly. The second word here, it's the second letter, it's the letter Mem, which comes from the word Michek. Let go of strongholds of evil. Michek is the stronghold of evil. Resist evil. Resist bribery. Resist evil. Well, what other letters we have? Ish Marecha. Shomer, we have the letter Reish in Hebrew. The letter Reish, according to Chazal, is the letter for the word Rasha, or wickedness. Avoid wickedness. Avoid things that are wicked. Do not be associated with wickedness. Do not be associated even in the appearance of evil. חס וחלילה, with evil itself. And the fourth letter in this ישמרך is the letter יוד, which is the יקח, meaning he wants to take you. You need to fight him. Fight evil. Fight bribery. Fight strongholds. In Midrash says that this is the definition of teshuva. Teshuva, it doesn't mean that you are perfect. Teshuva means that you are fighting something that is truly coming to destroy you. People make mistakes. They think that teshuva means that everything is perfect and you are sinless. No! What it means is in order for us to be ready for Geula, we have to do a constant teshuva. Fight today. If you sin today, get up today, and tomorrow you will do better. And the next day you will be better. This is the recipe of the Aaronic benediction here. And we have to understand this, okay? And it says the following. It says, this is the recipe to overcome the koach of the mazikim, the fight against the pestilence. For koach ha-mazikim is shochad, michek, rasha, ikach. Mashiach is calling upon you today from Edom. And he says, watch out for those things. I'm calling for you. I am fighting for you. And that's why this Aaronic benediction is the Aaronic benediction that ultimately, not just is sang by Bnei Aaron, but is sang over you by Mashiach Tzidkenu. Let's hear the sound of the Mashiach in those words. Yevechecha Adonai ve'ishmarecha. Overcome. The Yetzer Hara. This friend is Rekha Be'ivrit this week.